let's take a deeper dive on what this new piece of information could actually mean in the broader picture of the Russia investigation. With me, I have CNN legal analyst Michael Zeldin, who used to serve as Robert Mueller's special assistant when they were at the DOJ. Elizabeth Beck is back with us today, an attorney who deposed Donald Trump in 2011, and CNN contributor Walter Shaub, who quit his job as the director of the Office of Government Ethics under the Trump administration. He now works at the Campaign Legal Center. So happy Friday to everyone, and let's get to it. Michael Zeldin, just first to you, you know, based upon the president's actions in trying to fire Bob Mueller last summer, did the case for obstruction just get a bit stronger?
Well, Brooke, I'm not sure that the case for obstruction got stronger, but what got stronger was the window into the president's thinking for Bob Mueller, which is to say that in order for Bob Mueller to bring a case of obstruction of justice, he has to prove that the actor, in this case the president, acted with intent to obstruct. So to prove the intent, what's in a person's mind, is not easily done. It's done by circumstantial evidence. Here, with this allegation that he ordered McGahn to order Rosenstein to fire Mueller on bogus charges, he gives the Mueller interviewers an opportunity to see what his mental processes are, and then they can analyze all of his actions in relation to that. So it made the opportunity to understand the president's motives much simpler.
So on motives, let's just all look at this pattern of behavior, and I made this list here. You have the president telling Comey to stop looking into his former national security advisor, Michael Flynn. You have the Trump firing of Comey. Trump, you know, angry at his AG, Jeff Sessions, who recused himself from the Russia investigation. You have the president trying to have Mueller fired. And also in this New York Times piece, it reports that the president also considered firing the deputy AG, Rod Rosenstein. So again, this is all part of a bigger picture, Walter Shaub. And my question to you is, what does that pattern tell you about the president and perhaps repeated attempts to undercut this investigation?
Well, I think the president told us himself, didn't he, when he was on the air with Lester Holt and said he was thinking about the Russia investigation.
He did.
And in fact, your list highlights some of the strongest items, but there's also other things that if we're going to throw in the kitchen sink, we can start adding up, like his targeting of McCabe or his crowing about the reassignment of the general counsel at FBI or firing Sally Yates, which is presumably because of the immigration ban that she refused to enforce. But he could have actually just simply replaced her and put somebody else in the attorney general position long enough to enforce that ban.
So why are you subjecting me to this?
Sorry, I just heard a voice in my ear.
I did too. Whose voice was that? Was that you, Elizabeth? No. Okay. I don't know what's going on. Keep going, yeah. Walter. Go ahead.
So, you know, there's a lot of pieces floating around in there. Not all of them are conclusive. Some of them can